Hey everyone, I'm Lucas Kwiatkowski. I'm a full-time PPC manager. And if this is your first time here, the idea of the videos is to keep giving you guys more advanced videos on PPC and kind of my thought process and how I usually work through campaigns and accounts. I've been starting to get some feedback from people asking me to make videos analyzing software tools, why I use the ones that I do, and maybe doing some video reviews of those. That's definitely down the road. I want to start covering other topics, other advanced topics. One that I'm also very familiar with is split testing. That's a very advanced topic I think a lot of people forget about, using the software tool Splitly. It's not talked about a lot, so I am going to start to cover other topics, but PPC is the popular one. It's the one people want. It's the one I know best. So I'm going to keep trying to push out PPC videos, and then I'm very happy to keep taking suggestions on videos that you guys want me to walk through in the future. Now, this video is going to be short and sweet. It's going to be just kind of a hack and a time saver that I use on search term reports. Now, I still do go through search term reports manually. I think I have software tools that help me, but every once in a while, it's good to go through search term reports manually. See the raw data, see what it's doing, see how you can analyze it. So this is just a raw search term report, what happens when you download it and open it in Excel. And it's not easy to read. All of this stuff in the beginning, like, you know, currency, you don't need this. And the stuff you need is over here, and it's, you know, it's not sorted and all of that stuff. So a lot of people open search term reports, and then you can't really do anything with them. Now, if you see here, I open this up, I click a couple buttons on my keyboard, and boom, it's sorted for me. I have all of these campaigns sorted, so I can open them. So this is just one campaign. I have it sorted clicks from largest to smallest. I have all of the metrics here that I want listed, and then I took out some other columns. So I can collapse this, I can open up another one, I can see what that campaign is doing. And then one thing I forgot to do is freeze the panes. So it's very much easier to read to go through each of these campaigns, open them as you want, and then collapse them. All right. So I'm just going to walk through a very simple macro on Excel that if you're still doing your search term reports yourself, this is going to save you a bunch of time. All right. Now let's close this one out. This is the same exact search term report. All right. So what you do is you open it up, you come on the View tab here, you go Macro, Record Macro. Now, you can call it anything you want, and then you give it a shortcut. So this one, I think I need to do something different because I have a lot of mine already taken. So you give it the shortcut key, Control-Shift-R, and those are the buttons I just clicked. Once I open the search term report, I click those buttons and boom, it sorted everything for me. It was done. It was good to go. So once you do this and you click OK, then after this, every click that you do is going to be tracked. So it might take a couple times because you've got to do it right. So click OK. And now you can see here it's recording. All right. So what I do, this is just what I do. All right. This one doesn't happen to have portfolios. I'm still messing with portfolios and a few other high volume ones, but for now, I take them out. So I delete these ones, right? I make sure that everything can be seen on one screen. And then also what I want to do is just call this ACOS. I know what it is. Now, I do use these. But if you don't want to use any of these columns, return on ad spend is another way to look at ACOS. So let's just say we want to take all of these out. All right. And then I want ACOS and click-through rate. These are rounded to like a very high number of decimal places. I want those rounded to only two decimal places. And same with the click-through rate. That's not a percentage for some reason, so make that a percentage. All right, now I have everything I need. I can make click-through rate a little smaller. I can also just call it click-through rate. It's still tracking all of my clicks. After this is when you want to start doing your sorting. I like to sort clicks largest to smallest. That's how I like to look at search term reports. You sort this largest to smallest, And then you sort the campaign name from A to Z. So now you have, you see this campaign is sorted from clicks largest to smallest. And then we will get to the next campaign, sorted clicks largest to smallest. One last thing, you go to review, you go to data, you go to subtotal. This is where it makes everything look nice and clean. Now, at each change in campaign name, this you can really do anything you want. I like to just look at the spend. So I use function sum. So I'm going to sum up everything in spend. All right. So let's check that. Let's click OK. That's going to do that. And then you want to go to column two here. One last thing that I forgot to do in my last macro is freeze the top row and then click stop. And that's it. So now I've recorded that macro. Every time that I open a search term report and I click these control shift R, it's going to automatically put it into this format. Now, when you, so let's save this, right? When you exit out, it said, do you want to save the changes in your personal macro? Just click save in the startup folder. So that's fine. That still does it for me. Now, when I open this again, let me open up this search term report and control shift R. And look, everything is right there. And you can see that I fixed it. When I open up the first one, the top row wasn't freezing, but now the top row is in its place. I have all of these things where I want them. Even if you want, you can move some of these columns around so that every time you open a search term report, it's very easy to read. All right, so I do this. This has saved me a bunch of time because if you're still going through manual search term reports, they're impossible to read. So this was just a very quick hack, time saver. I hope you guys can implement this, and I hope that it helps you save time in your campaigns, and I look forward to making more videos in the future.